Welcome to the Pre-Snap Podcast presented by LineStar. Alongside my co-host Tyler Wiemann, I am Shannon Sommerville, and we've got your top five NFL prop bets for week five, specifically focusing on those Sunday games to give you plenty of time to get these entries in. Let's go crush it out there this week. We were 2-3 last week, so hoping to improve this week. Do us a huge favor before we get rolling here with our picks. Like this video, subscribe to our channel, comment below. It helps us out in the good old YouTube algorithm, but it also helps you out because if we go 5 for 5, one randomly selected commenter will win $100. If Tyler and I just go 2 for 2 on our picks, one randomly selected commenter will win $50. So got to be in it to win it. Drop your comment below. Let us know if you've got any locks for week five. It's certainly a great slate of games, and this is the best time of year. It is spooky season. We've also got baseball playoffs. We've got NFL games. So tons going on. But for NFL, we've got some great picks that you can find on Underdog, Sleeper, Chalkboard, Parlay Play. We've got links below. And the key is to use the promo code LineStar so you can get a nice deposit match. Plus, you'll also get one free month of LineStar. So take advantage of that deal. All right, week five. Great games on deck, including, of course, that London game. But I am steering clear of that, not only because I'm a Jets fan, but because I feel like any London game always ends up crazy. Weird things happen in London. Not sure what it is about the trip across the pond, but just weird things tend to happen in London. So staying away from that from a prop perspective. But if you've got any locks for that game, drop them below. Right now, though, we've got some great picks. Tyler, how are you feeling about week five? This is our bounce back week. I feel it.
You know, this is about the time I think that we start doing better. Just know a little bit more what's going on and see what teams are trying to do a little more. So I'm ready to go.
All right, well, let's do it. Let's start things off with Packers wide receiver Dontayvion Wicks over 46.5 receiving yards. I saw this stat, Tyler, and it kind of blew my mind a little bit. Did you know Dontayvion Wicks leads the NFL in separation percentage among receivers with at least 25 opportunities? He's created separation on 23 of 28 opportunities. In fact, that's like ahead of guys like Chris Olave, which is just crazy. And actually, Pro Football Focus has Wicks as a matchup to target in week five in fantasy, likely matched up against Rams' Kobe Durant, whose perimeter coverage grade ranks 59th among 65 cornerbacks. The Rams in general have been a great team. If you have opposing players for fantasy purposes, they rank 26th in explosive plays allowed. So Wicks is in a great spot because he's one of those players that's very boom or bust. He's been dealing with a couple drops here and there, but among 85 wide receivers with at least 395 receiving snaps from week one of last season to week four of this year, Wicks ranks 35th in yards per route run, 31st in target rate, 25th in yards after the catch per reception, 10th in explosive pass plays rate, and 2nd in missed tackles forced per reception. This is a guy who's got some skills, and given the opportunity, he can definitely make the most of it. He'll get that opportunity because Christian Watson is doubtful this weekend. Tyler, what is your assessment of Wicks going into this week?
So I want to go back to you talking about him separating. So he has 22 targets on the year. That is tied with Jaden Reed. Yet he has played 28 less snaps than Reed. He has played 70 less than Dobbs. And he has Dobbs has 20 targets to Wicks is 22. So he is going to be very, very involved without Christian Watson. Christian Watson has been out there four more snaps than Wicks. And that's just going to change this week. And I wouldn't be surprised if Wicks going forward for the rest of the year is out snapping Watson. I love his spot. Rams ranked 30th, allowing 175.9 yards per game to the wide receiver over the last nine. And then they're 32nd in yards per attempt at 9.1 per attempt. So I like the spot for Wicks to go over for sure.
And Tyler, we were kind of talking before the show, and this is one of those opportunities where you could maybe get a little higher payout if you bump up that line and take an alt line, right?
Yeah, I actually already bet 100 yards and a touchdown on him, and that was plus 1,000. So
wow,
$100 wins 1,100 or gets back 1,100.
Not a bad shot to take there on Wicks. All right, next let's go to Carolina Panthers running back Chuba Hubbard, over 59.5 rushing yards. The consensus projection around 66 consensus, basically kind of an average of all of the industry leaders and their projections. But Hubbard's averaging 74 rush yards per game and has really, seems like they've really found their rushing game since they had that change in quarterback to Andy Dalton. He's been over 100 rush yards the last two games, in fact, which corresponds with that quarterback move. Going up against Chicago, they're actually 20th in rush yards per game allowed to the running back position at 102 per game. They rank 30th in rush defense DVOA, which that stat takes into account the quality of opponent. And three of four opposing RB1s have actually gone over this 59.5 mark. Kyren Williams had 94, Jonathan Taylor 110, Tony Pollard 82. Chuba Hubbard's in a great spot, and I feel like he's only got a couple more weeks before Jonathan Brooks gets activated and maybe he loses some of those carries. But for right now, he's a guy that could win you a fantasy matchup, but also is just nice for this over on 59.5. What do you think?
Yeah, I like the spot. Chuba Hubbard's been averaging 5.5 yards per attempt. That is like 13th if you say anybody over 10 attempts here. So if you raise that line a little bit more, you know, he goes up quite a bit. For guys that have actually had a lot of volume, he's up there with the best of them. I mean, Derrick Henry, who has 80 attempts, is at 6 yards per target. He's at He's at 5.4. So he has actually been a very good running back. This O-line is solid. And now we have a good matchup, like you stated, where the Bears are 30th in DVOA versus rush.
All right. So Chuba Hubbard, a nice play for week five. Let's go back to a guy who we've picked consistently over the course of the first couple of weeks. He's kind of hit or miss, but Amari Cooper, over 51.5 receiving yards, seems a little low. LineStar's projection is 61.8. Yes, I know he's only averaging 37 receiving yards per game and has only gone over that 51.5 mark in one of four games. But this is a wide receiver. I mean, he just has been struggling with drops lately. I think he's been maybe a little bit unlucky, but going up against a defense that is very bad. The Washington Commanders, 32nd in EPA per play and EPA per pass. Cooper's in a great spot. If he's ever going to have like a triple-digit receiving yards game, this is the one. Again, Washington just hasn't been able to really contain opposing offenses, but they've been winning games lately, but mostly because of their offense. What's your take on Cooper's line here?
Oh man, it hurts me to keep going back here, but we just have to. He's fourth in the league in air yards with 470. He is 10th in the league in catchable targets. He is continuing to get lots of targets per game. It's just not coming together. The fact that he's getting that amount of catchable targets makes me think it's going to happen. And because of that, I kind of got to keep betting on it. One thing, you know, that I was thinking about is maybe I'm just playing Cooper a little wrong too, because we know throughout the years he is kind of boom bust. So maybe, you know, if you're on a sports book, you should go plus a higher line and get some plus money on him. To kind of combat some of that inconsistency we've seen of him. But 51.5, I think, is too low in this good of a matchup. So I like to try and go back here.
Yeah, especially since he's such a deep target threat that can put up a lot of yards and just a couple of receptions. And Deshaun Watson seems to be trying to move the ball down the field like they have been. It's just kind of unfortunate that the last one that he threw right at his chest, he just kind of coughed it right up and it ended up being an interception. Yeah. So hopefully they can kind of start to get on the same page a little bit more as the season progresses. And, you know, things happen, a little bit unlucky, having an off game. I just kind of am looking at it like, all right, off game, bad game for Cooper. Let's get back to playing real football this week.
And so I mean, he leads the league in drops. Yeah. Like, It and by double.
By a lot. Yeah. Yeah, this, by double. In second is actually Dontayvion Wicks with 4. He has been also played with some drops.
So he has 8 drops on the year. In all of 2023, he had 7 drops. So he's already crazy. dropped it more, and we just know that's not who Cooper is. So I had expect him to bounce back and, you know, start to put together some sort of consistency. We just haven't seen it yet.
All right. So those are our three picks. We're using the PropsAI tool on the LineStar app, again, to help us find the best value by comparing LineStar's projection to what's out there in the different sports books. Now it's time for Tyler and I to give our favorite player prop bets for week five. So what you rolling with, Tyler?
I'm going to go to Jake Ferguson, over 48.5 receiving yards. There's no Brandon Cooks. It is a super tough matchup for the wide receivers. Ferguson is their second option. They have no running game. The path to least resistance is through the tight end. And DVOA-wise, the Steelers are 22nd. So I like the spot for Ferguson. I think for this game, he's going to be targeted a lot, and they're really going to have to kind of move through him to be able to get some first downs together.
Yeah, I like Ferguson's spot here too, especially without Brandon Cooks in the mix. And you got to think like CeeDee Lamb is going to be double covered and everything. So that could open things up for Jake Ferguson, especially when defenses, we talk about the, you know, playing two high safeties and trying to take away the deep shot, like players like CeeDee Lamb, that kind of opens things up. And kind of the counter to that would be guys like tight ends getting the ball, you know, challenging your safeties to come down and tackle these big, you know, 6'4", 250 tight ends. So I like the spot here for Ferguson and Dallas, the Dallas Cowboys. All right, for my pick, I am rolling with, all right, I feel like there's going to be collective groans after I say this, but bear with me and hear me out. DeAndre Swift, over 48.5 rushing yards. Don't groan, okay? Listen to my explanation here. The consensus projection is around 50, averaging 40 rush yards per game. So, hey, I get it if you've been burned all season by DeAndre Swift, but he did have 93 last week versus the Rams. They ranked 32nd in rushing yards allowed. But going up against Carolina, they're 31st in rush yards per game allowed to the running back position. And since then, they lost their defensive star linebacker Shaq Thompson for the year. So a bad defense got even worse. They already had ranked 20th in explosive run plays allowed. And since the Bears are starting to run the ball a little bit more, and they seem to be kind of finding their rhythm a little bit on offense after last week, they realize, hey, we need to kind of have a more balanced approach on offense. They've started to run the ball a little bit more. And with Caleb Williams making plays with his receivers, it kind of opens things up a little bit for the run game to have success. And I like the Bears. They're 4.5 point favorites in this one, which if that indicates anything, it could be they get a lead and they just run the ball the rest of the game. So I like the spot here for DeAndre Swift. I know he had kind of a poor performance the first few games and his efficiency numbers were terrible, but I think that's also kind of a byproduct of the fact that the Bears offense has just been a little bit out of sorts. The offensive line's been terrible. They haven't been able to block right, but last week you kind of saw the lanes start opening up for the run game, and I expect that to continue against a very poor Carolina Panthers defense here. So we're rolling with Swift, the Georgia Bulldog, over 48.5 rushing yards here. Hey, I'm going to be in Georgia this week, so I figured out, you know what, if I'm going to plant my like flag in any prop, it's got to be a dog this week. Going to Athens to take on the Auburn Tigers, so got to show a little school pride in my prop bet show for NFL. Hopefully DeAndre Swift doesn't burn me, though, because then he might find himself on the do not bet list, which, you know, nobody wants to be on. The Mets and the Red Sox already know that's not a place anybody wants to be. Mm-mm. All right, so just recapping our top five picks here on our show. It's going to be Dontayvion Wicks, over 46.5 receiving yards. Chuba Hubbard, over 59.5 rush yards. Amari Cooper, come on, over 51.5 receiving yards. Jake Ferguson, over 48.5 receiving yards. And DeAndre Swift, over 48.5 rushing yards. Week five, let's get after it. If you've got any locks for us that we haven't shared yet, please comment below and share it with the group. We're all trying to help each other out and beat the books this week. Have a profitable week five. Good luck in all of your betting endeavors. And if you haven't already, check out our underdog picks as well, because that they can be used in both underdog and in the generic sports books as well. So that show is also up for week five. So check out our underdog picks as well. And good luck if you're playing DFS. Make sure to check out Tyler's DFS breakdown, where he gives you all the secrets and maybe things you didn't consider before you know, your DFS contest. Check that out as well. We've been having tons of content. Again, like this video, subscribe to the channel, comment below. Good luck in week 5. We'll see you guys next time.